BAM!
Mr. True, I'd like to take this opportunity to attempt to help you understand why cofunctions are equal to each other and actually what are cofunctions. So we're going to start off with an example here. I want to figure out what is equal to the cofunction. I'm not really going to tell you what it is right off the bat, but I want to find another trig function that has the exact same answer as the sine of 12 degrees. So, and I want to do this without the aid of a calculator. I just want you to, by the end of this video, go, well, the sine of 12 is equal to the blah, 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 blah. Only actually have real words in that sentence. So what are we studying? And by the way, we are going to be looking in this video, not angles in standard position, but just regular triangles sort of floating around in space. I actually do a lot of review of, or a little review, of what you learned in geometry. And that was from Sagittarius. Sine is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is equal to opposite over adjacent. So again, what do we mainly study in trigonometry? Yes, exactly, you are correct. We are studying right triangles and their rotations around the inside of a circle, mostly, but we certainly are, for the vast majority of the studies of trig, talking about right triangles. So when we see the sine of 12 degrees, that must mean that we're talking about a right triangle. Now, what do you put into a trig function? You put in an angle measure, whether it's in degrees like this or radians. And what do you get out of a trig function? Well, you get out the sides of a triangle. Now, again, I'm not going to do y over r because these are not standard position angles. I'm just going to draw a triangle just on the board somewhere. So I want to go back to Sagittarius, and so sine of an angle measure is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. So we must have a triangle that has a right angle, of course, because it's a right triangle, and it must have an angle of 12 degrees somewhere. Now I don't care if you draw like this or the 12 degrees is down here, it makes absolutely no difference. So I want, again, find another trig function that's equal to the sine of 12 without the aid of a calculator and just going through a bunch of calculations. Well, to help explain exactly why cofunctions are always equal, I want to take this example, I'm not going to do a proof, but a good explanation, and I want to just label the corners of this triangle and call it A, B, and C. Okay, and now what I'd like to do is label the sides. Now this is side BC, but how can I label this side in terms of only one letter? Do you remember that from geometry? You use capital letters for angles. Now, we use the theta, the Greek symbols, for the rotation or the angles in trig and precalc, but in geometry, we use capital letters for the corners, the vertices, and lowercase letters for the sides. And the matching side is opposite the given angle. So if this is angle A, this is going to be side A. If this is big B, angle B, then this is going to be labeled as little b. And then c, well, this is the hypotenuse, going to be little c. Okay, so yes, sine is opposite over hypotenuse, but now that I have this triangle labeled, let's lose the opposite over hypotenuse and actually fill in the sides that are appropriate for this triangle. Now side, now I just erased it, opposite over hypotenuse, so from A, the 12 degree angle, the opposite side is A, and the hypotenuse is C. So the sine of 12 is equal to A over C. Now, this is that, you know, you would not write this at all in your actual answer. I'm just explaining the concept to you. And now we're going to get to it. What trig function equals sine of 12? Well, if we're allowed to use this triangle, and be aware that we never set trig functions off of, at least in this kind of like just triangular trigonometry, we never set up trig functions based on the 90 degree angle. And indeed, if you looked at my unit circle videos, we can only set up reference triangles for those angles that are in quadrants 1, 2, 3, and 4. The 30, 45, and 60 angles, the 120, the 135, and the 150 angles, and so on. The 90, the 180, the 270, and the 360 or 0, those are quadrantal angles. It's not possible to set up a reference triangles for those angles. So we're not going to be setting up any trig functions off of 90, but we have 12 degrees and we have 78 degrees over here for angle B. And can you think of a sine, cosine, or tangent function using either one of these acute angles that is going to have the same ratio, the same answer as the sine of 12. Well, how about cosine? The cosine of, well, I can't do cosine of 12 because that would be B over C. But if I do the cosine of 78 degrees, you know, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, whereas sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Those aren't going to be the same ratio, but if I'm changing to the other angle inside of a right triangle from 78, cosine of 78 is adjacent over hypotenuse. So it's still going to be A over C. So do you see what's happening there? From 12, it was opposite over hypotenuse, and from the 78 degrees, A over C is the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So the sine of 12 equals the cosine of 78. And it's no coincidence that 12 plus 78 is equal to 90. It's no coincidence that these two angles are complementary, because how many degrees are inside of a right any triangle? 180. Well, in a right triangle, 90 is taken up with the right angle inside that right triangle, and that only leaves you 90 degrees left for the other two acute angles to share. So those other two acute angles are always going to be complementary. So what I've just shown you, not a proof, but just an example, close to a proof, is that the sine of 12 equals the cosine of 78, or indeed the sine of some given angle is equal to the cosine of the complement of that angle, or 90 minus theta. This is your first pair of cofunctions. Now I'm going to go a little faster and just give you the formulas, because the work actually is very, very simple for this concept. I just wanted to maybe take a few minutes and explain why it's actually true. Another formula is the cosecant, that's the reciprocal of sine, is equal to the secant, the reciprocal of cosine minus 90 minus theta. These are also, this is your second pair of cofunctions. And then finally, the tangent of theta is equal to the cotangent of 90 minus theta. This is your third pair of cofunctions. And these will work in reverse as well. So your textbook will either give you three little versions of this, or maybe six, to say something like cosine equals the sine of 90 minus theta. I like to kind of summarize the statement in, or these little tiny formulas, into a single statement. And that is, cofunctions are equal when their angles are complementary. All right? So there you go. That means that if I say, hey, what's equal to the tangent of 30 degrees? Or what's the cofunction to the tangent of 30 degrees? Well, that's just the cotangent. What's 90 minus 30? 60 degrees. What is equal to the cosecant of pi over 3, I'm going to cheat and use these same degrees only in radian version. The cosecant of pi over 3, which is 60 degrees, is going to be equal to the cofunction of cosecant is secant, and so the cosecant of pi over 3 is going to be the secant of pi over 2, that's 90, minus pi over 3. And if you know your unit circle, you might already know the answer is pi over 6, because 90 minus 60 is 30. But you can find common denominators. And I just miswrote that a little bit. And get the secant of 3 pi minus 2 pi over 6, which comes out to, as we already knew, the secant of pi over 6. So these should be the very, very easy questions of your next quiz or test. The sine of 10 equals the cosine of 80. The tangent of 20 equals the cotangent of 70. I'm starting to forget what I said. Cofunctions are equal when their angles are complementary. So, That's the rule, and I hope you understand why they're equal now. Bam! I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.